up, Leaderboard Gamers? This is Keegan coming to you live from Rooftop Coffee in beautiful Fernie, BC. I'm just rolling up to the cafe and I'll be running you through our coffee in this season of Leaderboard.
All right, so time for that reveal. The coffee you've been drinking is, and you probably can't read that, from the Cifuentes family in Bella Vista, Chiapas, in Mexico. I'm gonna be brewing a colita with it. So I find that the flat bottom brewer lends itself really well to this coffee because the slower drip time allows more of that body to come through, more of that kind of syrupy chocolate notes to come through. For those of you who are curious about my brew recipe, I'll be using 18 grams of ground coffee, and then I'll do a 40 gram bloom, and then I'll be going up to 300 grams of water in pulses, shooting for about a 3 minute brew time. So let's get that started. All right, so talking while brewing coffee is kind of hard. So I'm just gonna talk about this coffee while having my first few sips of the day. All right, so let's begin with how you would go about identifying this coffee in the game. So as a Mexican coffee from Chiapas, this one's grown very close to the Guatemalan border. So it'll be about a stone's throw away from Huehuetenango, which is also a very popular growing region in Guatemala. And for that reason, the characteristics between those two coffees will be pretty similar. I would say the biggest similarity is that malty, kind of chocolatey undertone. Certainly with lower altitude coffees from Huehue, I find that they have that malty, kind of reminds me of like a chocolate milkshake. And the coffees from Chiapas, especially, you know, the higher quality coffees from Chiapas, like this one, will have that malty chocolate, like melted chocolate kind of richness to them. So that would kind of identify the main region. So being, you know, I think the category is the Americas, and then that would maybe help you narrow it down to Mexico or Guatemala or even Honduras. And that would kind of get you in the general region. Getting it more specific to Mexico is a little bit trickier. Some of you, I was looking at the Discord, were on the absolute right track, and that is the distinct kind of spiciness, or kind of it's a toastiness. I saw some toasted marshmallow, which was awesome, some cinnamon. That kind of warm spice, it reminds me of a vanilla cookie, so maybe like a nutmeg. Yeah, it's more of like a spicy, rich aroma is the right word. that is how you'd kind of hone it in to Mexico as opposed to, let's say, Guatemala. I find coffees from Mexico have that really nice, depending on the region and the variety, obviously, but washed coffees from Chiapas tend to have a lovely, spicy nuttiness to them. So this is reminding me of macadamia nut, reminding me of, yeah, like I said, vanilla cookie. And you're all on the right track as far as I saw in the Discord, so that's awesome. Honing it in on variety, this is relatively straightforward, so it's a washed coffee. It won't be overly funky like a honey or a natural. Then honing it in on elevation. This is grown at 1,550 meters, I believe. So as a middle altitude coffee, it won't be a complete, you know, mouth bomb of an acidic coffee, but it'll be nice and balanced, and that hopefully will come through in the cup. A roast machine, you'll see here we have our Probatone P12. We affectionately call it Tony. I've always had a hard time identifying the roast machine, so good luck to you and congrats if you got that one right, but now you know it's a traditional drum roaster. Finally, I believe varieties. So this is a blend of three different varieties, Caturra, Bourbon, and Catimor. Identifying blends is difficult. It's probably easiest to notice that it's a blend from the visual inspection of the beans. So you'll see that it's a variety of bean sizes and shapes. That would probably get you on the right track of it being not just one variety, because it's not, you know, super uniform. Then from the taste perspective, Caturra and Bourbon, those are kind of the classic coffee varieties that were initially planted in Mesoamerica. So those ones I find will bring kind of that stewed fruit, the sweetness, the acidity, kind of the structure to the cup. I am reminded of raisin when I think of when I drink this coffee. So that to me kind of hints towards the Caturra and the Bourbon. If you had Caturra from Nariño, for instance, I feel like I get like super clean yellow fruits is kind of where I go. So bring that down a few meters of elevation, a few hundred meters of elevation, and you get into that kind of raisin, date, dried fruit territory. Then Catimor, That's a hybrid with the Timor hybrid, I believe is what it's called. It's got some Robusta lineage to it. So that brings pest resistance, which is really important for farming. But from a flavor perspective, you may have had Catimor from China or Indonesia, and that's where the kind of spicy, nutty, earthiness comes in. I find the best coffees from Indonesia, the best coffees from China or other countries in that region have that distinct herbal earthiness to them. And this comes through in this coffee and that kind of nutmeg, cinnamon, spice. So that would be a rough guideline for honing in on the varieties and the other stats that are important to the leaderboard. Hopefully that's helpful. Hopefully most of you got it right. If not, then, you know, it's the way the game goes. I certainly had a hard time getting most things right when I played. What else? I would love to talk about how we source this coffee. This is a coffee from Mayan Harvest, which is an export company based in Bella Vista, which is the town where this coffee was grown. Mayan Harvest is run by Rosalba Cifuentes, and she is from the area. I grew up on a coffee farm, and now she runs this export company that brings coffees directly from Chiapas up to North America. And I had heard about her coffee because it was being roasted by Mother Tongue, I believe. She brings in Rosalba brings in a lovely women's producers co-op, which was featured in a few roasters' shelves, and that's how I kind of caught wind of the work she was doing and spotlighting her hometown. And so I wanted to bring in her coffees for some time, but they're quite popular. And then finally, Brandon at Royal Coffee got in touch with me this spring, said that he had some of her coffees coming to Vancouver, and I wanted to bring some of it in. So I brought it in this spring for the first time. I think it'll be a staple on our menu going forward if I can keep bringing it in, and I intend to do so. And yeah, this one is grown. It's not the women's co-op, which is the more famous one from Mayan Harvest. It's from four of her uncles and cousins who still farm in the Bella Vista area. So it's a family lot, a variety of farms, which is why you get probably the variety of different cherries in there. And it's a beautiful example of the town. I love getting these kind of community blends because it gives you an idea of what that region's coffee tastes like. And I just love bringing in Mexican coffees. We've been featuring them for the last 2 years now, and it's been such a delight getting to see the variety of coffee from this one country. You know, coffees from Oaxaca or Veracruz, which are different parts of Mexico, will have pretty different characteristics as well. And you're starting to see farmers kind of push the boundaries with their processing as well. But this is just a great example of a classic washed Mexican coffee. And if you come by Fernie, you'll probably find it on our espresso bar, and you'll be able to try it as any of your favorite espresso drinks. So that's it from me regarding this coffee. Rosalba Cifuentes and family from Bella Vista, Chiapas. And I hope you all enjoyed.
So I still have about 10 minutes until somebody comes in to open the cafe. So I figured this would be a good time to give you a quick tour.
So this is our coffee bar. We're located in historic downtown of Fernie, which is a mountain town in the Canadian Rockies. This building used to be a bank, and then it was a cafe, and then it was a few other things, and then now we moved in here. Opened the cafe at the end of 2019. This is our San Remo Cafe Racer. A little bit of a maintenance issue over here, so it's a temporary two-group machine. We got our San Remo grinders here. And this is kind of the rest of the food prep barista area. Got our retail shelf over here. A bit more seating. And then back here is the roastery, which is where the magic happens. And this is our roastery. It's a little bit chaotic because we had a roast day yesterday and probably going to be doing more roasting today. But it's a tight functional space right behind the cafe, so get plenty of waves from people through the window. We got our Probat here, which I showed you before, Tony. And then we have our green storage here, which a bit tight on space, so we're constantly getting shipments in of various lots from all over the world. This is the cupping area. Got our grinder, the Ikawa there. I'm cracking into the Ford lottery right now. And this is the roasting area where we spend most of our time.
So this right here is the home roaster. I actually got started on when I was first roasting back in high school on the rooftop of this very building, which is a bit of a longer story, but yeah, a little bit of a tribute to our roots right there.
Well, that's it for me. I hope that helped you identify the coffee a little bit better if you had some issues with that throughout this season.
I hope this gave you a bit of a better idea of who we are here at Rooftop, and I hope you enjoy the rest of this season's reveals. Happy brewing.